Hey, good to see you. Welcome to today's video. It is the juxtaposition between examination, test, scan, study, and trial. And before I even launch in, let me start by checking in with you and inquiring how you guys are. I really do hope everyone is well and making the most of these unusual times. What I want to focus on today are several English terms, all of which can be translated into Polish as badanie. I'm also going to be talking about their synonyms. Let's start with physical examination. Our most immediate association with the term physical examination, physical exam, or physical, is probably something like this. Physical examination is also sometimes referred to as medical examination, clinical examination or assessment, and it can be defined as the process of evaluating signs and symptoms through the use of inspection, auscultation, palpation, and percussion. Inspection is the process of seeking physical signs by observing the patient thoroughly. Auscultation is the process of listening for diagnostic purposes to the sounds made by movement of gas or liquid within the body. Palpation is the process of examining part of the body by touching or feeling with the hands and fingers. And percussion is the process of tapping or thumping on a part of the body with the finger or a pleaser, and sensing the resultant vibrations. And I've got a nice story about this technique. It's a technique discovered fairly recently by an Austrian innkeeper's son named Leopold Auenbrugger. What he did was watch his father take inventory by tapping wine barrels with his fingers to check how much alcohol was left. And years later, while practicing medicine in Vienna, he applied this technique to his patients and published the first description of the diagnostic utility of percussion in 1761. So, inspection, auscultation, palpation, and percussion are different examination techniques. But physical examination is typically preceded by history taking. And interestingly enough, history taking can be translated into Polish as badanie. Interviewing patients to elicit their health history includes several stages, such as greeting the patient and establishing rapport, or in other words, establishing a good relationship, setting the agenda, which basically means finding out everything that the patient wants to attend to, while also getting the presenting complaint or complaints by inviting the patient's story and exploring the patient's perspective. The next step would be taking the following as appropriate: past medical history, family history, social history, sexual history, drug history, and travel history. History taking typically ends with the review of systems, though some clinicians do the review of systems during the physical examination. Unfortunately, it's often the case that history taking and physical examination are not enough to give a diagnosis, and additional or accessory investigations are needed. These may include laboratory tests, such as tests on blood, urine, and other body fluids. And yes, you're right if you're suspecting that the term test translates into Polish as badanie. Diagnosis is further aided by biopsy, investigations consisting in recording the electrical activity of different organs, examination of body cavities by means of an endoscope, and diagnostic imaging techniques such as radiography, computed tomography or CT, and magnetic resonance imaging or MRI. A CT scan uses a combination of X-rays and a computer to create pictures of various organs, whereas MRI is a type of scan that uses strong magnetic fields and radio waves to produce detailed images of the inside of the body. The last term that I wanted to talk about is a clinical study. There are two main types of clinical studies: clinical trials, also called interventional studies, and observational studies. In a clinical trial, human volunteers receive specific interventions according to the research plan or protocol created by the investigators. These interventions may be medical products such as drugs or devices, procedures, or changes to participants' behavior such as diet. Clinical trials test whether the new or different treatment is safe and effective by comparing it to a standard one that is already available, to a placebo that contains no active ingredients, or to no intervention. All in all, there are several English equivalents of the Polish term badanie, and it's of vital importance to know the conceptual difference between them and to adjust your translation to convey their meanings. And now you can test yourselves by taking the short quiz. Was helpful. I'll put the terms we've discussed today and their translation in the description box below, together with the link to my book, Medical English in Translation. I especially recommend chapter 16. I also recommend an interesting article by Mariusz Górnicz from the University of Warsaw for a further reading. Take care of yourselves and each other, and I'll see you guys soon.